What's up, channel? It's your boy, The Concise King. Welcome back to yet another Apex Legends video, some more Season 7 content for your needs. Today's video is going to be done a little differently today, y'all. It's going to be a bit more shorter. Actually, it's going to be an insider video. I actually wanted to specifically bring you guys this video to shed a little light on, you know, bring a little hope, maybe crush your spirits a little bit to the fact that we are never getting quads. Yes, y'all heard it right, and maybe you've heard it before, but the idea of a four-man team in the Apex Legends arena has been scrapped, it has been debunked, eliminated. I want you guys to just know that it is not very likely to happen. Why? Well, there's an array of reasons, and we're going to get into that into today's video, so thank y'all for tapping in. I thank y'all for stopping by. Let's get right to it. So guys, if you haven't figured out by now, today's video is slightly different from what I am normally doing. I'm more of like relaying news to you guys today, Apex Legends news in this case. So just a couple days ago, a few Apex Legends creators, as well as a game designers behind a lot of Season 7, as well as a director of comm, a lot of them were just responsible for the design. They took to Reddit to answer a field of community questions and just give some feedback. And before I move on, I just want to, you know, give them a little kudos, because in this gaming world, interaction and accountability, we freaking love it, Apex Legends. And I'm actually gonna post a photo, and I hope you guys can see it right there in parentheses. It says, yes, including the battle pass and accountability. We love it. It's just, that was just a little giggle when I saw that. But yeah, they basically took to Reddit, guys, to answer some feedback, and a minor critique that actually stood out to me, or at least one that I picked out on. I'm actually gonna try to post this video in here. As far as in the video that you guys are watching, when you go down and your teammates are literally intentionally unsupporting you, they are intentionally not reviving you, they maybe want to get all the kills, they're in a trios match, they're maybe in a ranked match, and they are doing, they're partied up, they are not trying to revive you whatsoever, they actually let you bleed out. I saw that video and that immediately got me outraged, because there just has to be some kind of immediate support and report system for that. But we're not talking about that into today's video. But next to concerns of that nature was the big old question. Can we expect quads in the Apex Legends future? So guys, as reported by PC Gamer here, you guys can definitely check out the article. I'm going to leave it in my link description below. As reported by PC Gamer, design director of Apex Legends, Jason McCord, he wrote, "We don't have any plans to release quads. We needed to decide this early on in testing. Trios is the magic number for us. That's when the legend composition really shines and the X-Men versus Avengers fantasy starts to shine through. When you play quads, which we tested early on, the combat becomes nearly untrackable. It's chaotic in a negative way." Let's just break down this sentence before we even move on. When you play quads, which we tested on early on, the combat becomes nearly untrackable. It's chaotic in a negative way. If we're looking at adding quads, guys, we're looking at third parties. We know that third parties will continue to exist. Hey, less third parties. No, hell no. Third parties are always going to exist. Don't even try it. Shorter recovery time. We're looking at shorter recovery time. Of course, we're like already losing our shit when we're looking at third parties and coming to kill us, and we're trying to recover, we're trying to revive that teammate. Now we're looking at even more shorter recovery times, because that whole four-man team is going to attack you even harder, y'all. Another thing that we are looking at, if we're adding comms, this is just from my point of view, we are looking at uncontrollable comms, y'all. We can still be in a party, it doesn't even matter, we can all be in game chat, but everybody just feels like all that they're saying is going to be important all the time, like even now. So I need to be able to hear, of course I want to hear that person who's telling me that they're fletching everybody, because that's good comms, I need that too. But I'm also going to need to be able to hear that guy who's like, hey, we're about to get third party. So, you know what I mean? So that was just my point of view from what I took from this first quote here. Let's move on. So then guys, moving on, Jason goes on to describe just a few solvable issues that kind of would hinder quads had it ever come to fruition. And so he goes on to say, this chaos wouldn't be a total deterrent for a limited time mode if the rest of the game wasn't designed around trios. Our lobby, for example, is designed for three people. Our loot distribution is designed for three people per squad. Even something like banners placed around the map don't have room for a fourth. These are all technically solvable problems with enough effort, but because we feel that trios is the sweet spot, we aren't pursuing quads currently. Sorry, I had to pause there because I had a total whole new thought. Actually reading this whole quote, all hope is not lost for me, because I'm a guy who's just going to take out a few keywords. But he said, this wouldn't be a total deterrent for a limited time mode. if I'm putting limited time mode together. Let's use a little context clues. If I put limited time mode together, back up to his earlier quote of yes, we have tested, piled with yes, these are solvable problems. We are looking at Apex Legends, as much as they're like, nah, bruh, it ain't happening. We're still looking at Apex Legends like, maybe it could, you don't know. I mean, we've tested it, like, we have the stuff, like, we could, like, maybe we'll drop it, we don't know. Like, that's just what I get from reading this whole quote here. And I'm also gonna stick with the idea of we aren't pursuing quads currently. We are not pursuing quads currently. You know, saying that they say that they're not pursuing quads currently, let's just look at the history of Apex and how they've been rocking with us. This could be a huge instance of Respawn saving us at least from some trouble, maybe a little bit of anger. What do you mean by that? I started playing Apex this year, February. It was season 4. I think they've been the most interactive. They've been the most accountable and responsive game design team that maybe I've ever known. Maybe I've ever seen. You guys can fight me on that for sure. For instances in the past, the jump to fix Pathfinder after all of that outrage. To know that they were listening, to know that they acknowledged the jump to fix and roll out and re-roll out the battle pass, y'all. They're at our request. My God, they had to hop on that. The introducing of the armor overhaul in season six, you know, where you're essentially landing with a evil shield that you have the possibility of leveling up. I think I hit my mic every time I record. But yeah, the idea of leveling up. These are all things that, you know, I feel like they want to be interactive with their Apex Legends players, with their Apex Legends community. But if we're adding on top of that, maybe why they're also so hesitant for a quads is because they're trying to get those new gamers still, guys. They're still trying to get, you know, those new followers to come on and to hop on this game. You know, there can't be, there continue to be millions of me who hop on this game this year and you're like, oh, this is very difficult. Of course, I didn't get discouraged enough to stop the game, but I can see that happening. A lot of players I come in, you know, I get into lobbies with randoms and they're like, yo, how do you get level 500, bro? Like, I've been playing this game since the first season. Although I did stop, you know, in season 2, season 3, you know, I stopped for a couple seasons, but how did you get level 500? And so I guess, you know, Apex is trying to, maybe they're trying to make this game a bit better in a way that it can keep all of their players interactive, that they can keep all of their players, you know, trying to find some kind of progression. That battle pass was not it. My God, they were going to lose a lot of players with that damn battle pass. Even people were returning for season 7, for Olympus, for Ascension, and they're like, oh no, are you guys really going to do this to me right now? And so Apex Legends, you know, I'm not even trying to shoot them some bail, but they actually have been on top of it. Because they have to be on top of it. We're not letting them go by and get by easily with it. To be honest, guys, I keep referencing the hiccup with the battle pass because centered around that, and even centered around those comments in the Reddit community, there's that notion that Apex does not do enough to deliver more updated content, better game modes, even better skins, y'all. That's actually something that really stood out to me. I was like, these gun skins can be much better. These characters, legend skins can be much better. And I've also been put onto the idea that they've actually just been re-rolling out some of the same skins for the weapons things, some of the skins that did better, legendary skins that did better in the earlier seasons, as well as the guns. So there's constantly that tension around whenever we do things new from Apex. Why is it slightly still the same? Why is it like you guys are being a bit lazy with it? To which, of course, the game director, Chad Bernier, definitely had to come out and I feel like they have to reassure us every season that everything that they do, they always have our interests at heart and mind, so that the next time for future seasons, for future rollouts, always assume positive intention. And I'm like, Chad, it's a little hard when you're like giving us a battle pass that like requires me to kill 50 people at once to get one star. That was a lot of exaggeration, but that's what it felt like. Listen, y'all, this has been a very, like, extremely difficult and very complex year for just a lot of us, right? And again, I'm not trying to shoot Apex Legends some bail. So even in the midst of this pandemic, I think Respawn is doing the most of what they can with what they can. And I'll add on to that, Chad also mentions in the rest of these Reddit notes, which I think you guys should definitely go check out and just, you know, you'll find that a lot of what you think, a lot of what you see in the game is just on there, living right there already. He goes on to mention not wanting to crunch the team, i.e. pressure them, push them for time. They said that they're probably going to be making more content. We'll probably be getting it at a slower pace for the simple fact that he's not trying to push them to pull 15-hour days, which they have been doing in the past. So we're still going to be getting some content, but it's just going to be at the pace that we've been getting it now. I want to say that, guys, I started in February, right? That was season four. They started, this game started with 8 legends. They rolled out 15 so far. They roll out a new season every 2 to 3 months. They are pushing, y'all. We are in season 7. I started in season 4. We're in season 7 right now. I think they are working, y'all. If you're looking at Call of Duty, if you're looking at any of these other games, man, these huge updates that take forever to download. And adding on to that, I think that what we can ask for any thriving business, any successful business, any place that we are willing as consumers to give our money to, all that we can ask for is a line of communication, of interaction, of accountability. We know how good of a game this is, and so we just want the best of it. And they know how much we love the game, so they want us to enjoy it as much as we can, even through all of its difficulty. But listen, guys, I hope that you guys can see why maybe we're not getting quads, why maybe I'm not pushing for it. I'm not so surprised if we get it. I would like to enjoy it if it was a light game mode, a limited time game mode for sure. But I don't see quads coming anytime soon. Not even for the sake of the game designers having to put it together, but I just don't think the vast majority of the Apex Legends players in the community are ready for it. I really don't think we are. 1v1s itself are something that a lot of people have trouble with. And, you know, this game is really, it puts you in positions where you have to think for everyone, and including yourself. There's a lot of point of views to consider. But listen, guys, that's all I got for today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope you guys got some new information, learned some new information. I want to shout out to PC Gamer for the relayed information, as well as Apex Legends for holding it down, for doing their thing. To boy TheeConciseKing, I thank y'all for tapping in. I thank y'all for tuning in. Catch me streaming on Sunday. It's going to be on YouTube this week as well, guys. Sunday, I think it's going to be at 3 p.m. You guys can also follow me on Twitch. I stream from there from time to time. Schedule is coming soon. If you are new to the channel, consider liking, subscribing, and sharing. I make Apex Legends content as well as instructional Apex Legends guides so that we can better understand how to wield these legends. This is my first insider / review of a video. I think it went well, guys, but until then, I'll see you next time. Peace. Keep gaming. Be safe. Keep the love. Keep the health. One love.